And can I introduce you to three Queen's of Commonwealth scholars?
Yes.
Simon, who's doing agriculture. He's from Kenya, and he's studying at the University of Victoria. Tumi is a UJ student.
Hi, hello. Very nice to meet you.
Ross is a community.
Fantastic. Well, it's good to meet you. I'm so happy to have all of you here today.
Your Royal Highness, the Duchess of Sussex, in my hometown there is a saying that says that if you want to feed a village, you have to empower a woman.
Whether you're doing cutting edge research, reaching out to marginalised communities, working with schools and colleges.
Thank you. Thank you all so much for having me. I'm really so excited to be here. Obviously, as patron of the ACU, it's been an incredible, almost a year now, a little bit over a year, really working to advocate for what is truly and deeply important and meaningful to me on a personal level. Education, I think higher education specifically, is such a key element for growth, economic growth, but also personal growth and development.
It's heartfelt and it's really important.
If you don't have the support that is necessary, that you feel that you can keep taking the next step, then you're stunted in your growth, right? And so much of that is, of course, having the support and scholarships and funding for students who are eager to learn. I went to university. It takes a village, doesn't it, to sort of piece it together for people to be able to finance that, be it families chipping in, scholarships, financial aid, all those things that were the reason that I was able to attend university. But at the same level, you need to have that kind of support on the inside for educators to be able to give as much as they can back to those who are in the educational system.
And so we're creating a gender detour, a pathway where students walk a path.
Very, very happy that we're able to announce today three new gender grants. This is key. Obviously, they are going to be in universities that are here, University of Johannesburg, Stellenbosch University, and University of Western Cape. And the goal here is to be able to have gender equality, to be able to support women as they are working in research and higher education roles, and also to be able to have workshops to convene things that are really helping people understand the importance of gender equality. You know, true to what you said, when a woman is empowered, it changes absolutely everything in the community. And starting in an educational atmosphere is really a key point of that.
What are the barriers that as privileged people, as men, as white people,